To access the SIP portal user guide, please log in to your Integra Care account. Go to your SIP Trunking Resource Center and click on the link SIP Portal User Guide. This user guide will allow you to see step-by-step instructions and screens to help you to use your SIP portal. To log into the portal, you simply click on the Admin Portal Login from Integra Care. You would put your main number here. So for the example, I'm going to use my main number and your password and log in. Okay, so this is the main screen of the portal. The portal will give you access to set up call forwarding, call blocking, and call screening. These features will be set up for the entire group of DIDs on your PBX with the exception of unavailable call forward that can be set up for the entire group of DIDs on the PBX or individual DID. Setup will be activated when the PBX or SIP trunks are unavailable. For call barring or call blocking, as the administrator, you can block specific outgoing call types that are not explicitly controlled by Integra. An example of this is that by default, Integra blocks international dialing, but only blocks premium calls, 900-976, specifically requested by the customer. Using the SIP portal, you can block or allow these types of calls as needed. Control of blocking or allowing international calls will only be given to administrators when the customer has specifically requested international dialing and has signed the appropriate waivers and agreements. Without this agreement, the international block will always be active and the customer will be unable to change this. So for call barring or call blocking, you want to go in to your settings. And then your call tab, calls tab. And then you can choose call blocking. And this will allow you to determine what block you want to apply. So international is automatically blocked. Premium is automatically blocked. But you can block operator by simply clicking it. You can block certain directory calls or just uncheck it and then simply say apply. Call forwarding services. Call forwarding allows all calls to forward to a single selected number based on a variety of conditions such as immediately, busy no answer, unavailable, and selected callers for all telephone numbers into the PBX, except for unavailable. You can program this feature per specific DID or all lines. This would be under Call Manager. Under Call Forwarding Services, Immediately Call Forwarding. This option feature allows all calls to be forwarded to a user-defined telephone number. Busy No Answer Call Forward. When the line is busy or there is no answer, calls can be forwarded to a user-defined telephone number. Unavailable Call Forward. When the PBX or CPE becomes unreachable, calls are forwarded to a user-defined telephone number. Selected callers, this allows calls that originate from a specific caller to be forwarded to a user-defined telephone number. And then here's your forwarding destination. Okay, so if you want to forward all calls to an outside party, when your PBX is unavailable or your SIP services are unavailable. Call manager, forwarding, unavailable. So you click forward calls if my PBX is unavailable and click apply. If you want to forward selected callers, you need to click on DIDs. If you want to call forward a specific DID, you would click on the button opposite of that number. Click forwarding. Forward calls if my number is not available, and then the number here that you want to forward to. And click apply. Call forwarding. Forwarding destinations, they can add work and add, and they can do home, cell, and then they're available for you to pick from. And click apply. Then you can choose what number you want to forward to and say apply. Caller ID presentation. This basically allows you to block or unblock outbound caller ID on all calls made from your location. In order to get to your caller ID presentation, you would click on settings, click calls, open the general box, and click withhold and apply. If you want to allow caller ID to be transmitted or be presented, unclick and click apply. Call screening will allow you to block incoming anonymous calls or calls from a specific number. Anonymous call rejection. Incoming calls are rejected when the calling party does not provide the caller ID information, or you can choose selective call rejection. This option feature enables a user to exclude calls that originate from a specific caller. To get into your call screening, you would click on the Call Manager tab. You would click Screening. And you can reject calls to my PBX from a selected caller. And then you could edit this list and add numbers. Click OK. And now any call from that number is rejected. If you need to remove that, clear list, and then add 425. Add new, click OK, and click apply. If you click on screening and anonymous call rejection, and you click on that, you would reject any calls to your PBX if the caller ID is not available or presented from the person calling into your business.